So hello everyone, today we are going to perform structural analysis of deep drawing using an Ansys workbench. So deep drawing is a process of converting flat blank or sheet into a hollow shape like product or cylindrical product. So deep drawing consists of die, punch and a blank holder and a material. So when this punch moves downwards, it will make flat blank go into the die, ultimately giving us cylindrical like component. But in our case, we have a punch which is displaced about 50 mm downward direction. Die and the blank holder is fixed and titanium alloy is used. So the topics like all these topics will be covered in this video. So geometry. So we'll be using deep drawing all the components, and we'll be discussing rigid bodies, flexible bodies, sheet material, that too a non-linear material, because this is also known as non-linear analysis because of our sheet has to deform in plastic region. So permanent deformation has to take place. That's the reason non-linear material has to be considered, and contact regions, contact rules, mesh, loads and boundary conditions, analysis settings, all those things. Now let's come back to Ansys. So this is Ansys workbench. Selecting static structural, go to engineering data. Here we have structural steel. Now engineering data resources, general nonlinear materials, go to titanium alloy. Now we have two materials, structural steel by default, titanium alloy nonlinear. Now nonlinearity because this particular titanium alloy, this particular material has plasticity in it. So as you can see here, here we have a graph consisting of two straight lines. The first straight line represents the elastic region of titanium alloy, and the next straight line represents the plastic region of titanium alloy. So our deformation has to take place in the plastic regions, hence the reason we are using non-linear material. So now, but for structural steel there is no non-linearity. So structural steel, all the properties we have is in the elastic region. So now import geometry. Now edit in design modeler. Now click on generate. So now we have a deep drawing components. We have four components: die, punch, blank holder. So now this is not a complete geometry or a model of deep drawing. It is a quarter model of deep drawing. So this structural analysis and nonlinear analysis of deep drawing takes a lot of computational resources and a solving time. So to reduce the computational resources and the solving time, we have at a different stages, we have simplified our problem. So for example, in this geometry case, instead of taking full geometry or the half geometry, we have considering quarter model. Perhaps the simplest model is the axis symmetric model. We can also use the axis symmetric model. That will be the simplest geometry, but we are using quarter model geometry. So now let's just name it each component die. This is blank and this is punch and this is blank holder. Now this geometry is created using Ansys design modeler. The video link is in the description as well as in the comment. please do check it out. Now let's just close the design modeler. So now under model, so this is geometry part, die blank punch blank holder. Now we'll again perform some simplification. We'll be changing, so if you can see, all the material is flexible material. Now let's just change punch blank holder from flexible to rigid body. Now this is another simplification, so to reduce the computational resources and the time. Since we are making all die, punch and blank holder a rigid body, the stress development, strain, displacement and deformation will not be calculated to these components, so thereby computational and solving time will get reduced. So now only the blank is a flexible body, because we want all the results but related to stress, strain, displacement, deformation. You are interested in the blank result, so that's the reason blank is a flexible body. Now if you see here, we have two materials, titanium alloy and structural steel. For structural steel there is no non-linear behavior, for titanium alloy there is a non-linear behavior. Now let's just coming to blank. I'll change by default it is structural steel for all the components. Now let's just change blank from structural steel to titanium alloy. Now we'll just add symmetric condition, because this is a quarter model. The symmetric region, let's just duplicate it. Now first select face filter, select this side of face of blank. This face is normal to z-axis, change symmetry normal to z-axis. Now coming to this, select this face and it is symmetric normal to x-axis, by default x-axis.